Nurses is taped in front of a studio audience.
Listen, Fred, I gotta work tomorrow, so I need you to give out the Halloween candy. What do you mean you ate it all? So go buy some more. No, Fred, no trick-or-treater's gonna want a fistful of beer nuts.
Fred's giving out the candy this year, huh?
Does he do anything to scare the kids?
Oh, yeah. He sits on the porch in that old polyester jogging suit of his, trimming his toenails. Scares the hell out of the kids and the neighbors.
What are we all enjoying so much?
Oh, nothing.
Annie. Sometimes I feel like I'm just not part of the gang. Why is that?
Well, gee, I don't suppose it's because you threatened to fire everybody here at least twice.
Well, that doesn't mean I can't be part of the gang. Hey, it's Hank and Gina. They're back from San Pequeno, everyone.
Oh, and already dressed for Halloween, I see.
We came directly from the airport to make a special announcement.
Gina said, yes, we are engaged to be married.
That is just terrific. When will you be coming back to work, dear?
Well, I am getting married, so I have a wedding to plan, and then I thought I'd have the baby. Then a small amount of recovery time would be nice.
Oh, you take all the time you need, secure in the knowledge that your paid vacation ended 9 days ago.
So, this must be an exciting time for you.
Well, I am feeling a little woozy.
Well, I don't blame you with all the wedding plans.
And the morning sickness.
All the emotion and the queasiness.
And the romance.
The dry mouth.
And now you're getting married.
So much to think about. What are you going to do first?
I think I'm going to be sick.
How's Gina feel?
Oh, she must feel better. I brought her back to my place to rest. She ended up cleaning.
Yeah, I hear pregnant women really get that nesting instinct.
Well, actually, it started with her clearing a path to my bathroom. Ended up with all my guy stuff in a box. But, Paco, it's all yours now.
Mine?
Yeah, I'm passing the bachelor torch on to you. Yeah, including my little black book. Yeah, I guess I won't be needing that special item anymore.
I guess not. There's only two numbers in here. And one of them's your dentist.
Annie, I've been thinking. You people put me on a pedestal so high, you're afraid to be my friends.
Well, if that works for you.
You know, I want to be part of the gang. You know, I'm just not a corporate businesswoman sitting in her ivory tower. I'm a very, very warm person. It's all here in this memo.
Gather around, gang. I have an announcement to make.
I want to invite you all to my house tomorrow night for a Halloween/get-to-know-me party.
You're really inviting us to your home?
You bet.
That's great.
All right. What time?
Oh, Jack, when I said everyone, I didn't know you were standing there. But just to show the gang how fun and spontaneous I can be, you're invited too.
What?
No. Just because we shun and distrust Jack at work doesn't mean we can't shun and distrust Jack at a party as well.
Think about it.
Happy Halloween, my subjects.
Cleopatra, Miss McAfee, you look terrific.
Oh, thank you, Julie. And don't you make the cutest little kangaroo?
Marsupial. See, a kangaroo has a long and powerful tail. I ran out of fabric. So technically, I'm a marsupial, not specifically a kangaroo or a possum or a wombat or...
Oh, whatever you are, I'm very impressed. It clearly took a lot of work.
And I'm Dr. Bunny. Yeah, short notice, low budget. It's the best Gina could come up with.
Oh, how is Gina? I'm so sorry she couldn't come tonight.
Oh, she really wishes she could come, but she's feeling better.
Oh, will you tell her to please call me if she needs anything?
Oh, that's nice. It's genuinely nice. Stand and deliver.
Why, Jack, for a minute there, I thought maybe you weren't coming.
Hood, ma'am. The name is Robin Hood. I steal from the rich and hope they don't notice. Wow, what a costume. Looks like I picked a bad night to wear tights.
What's that in my quiver? What is that? Something special for the hostess?
Just a split of champagne, just enough for two.
Oh, isn't that nice? Yeah. Why don't you split it with Hank?
Hey, guys on Fox City, let's swing!
Paco, you're wild and crazy!
That's your problem, sick machine!
Great costume. You must have searched all over town for those ridiculous 70s clothes.
No, actually, they were in a box of stuff Hank gave me.
It was my costume from last year.
And your work clothes from the year before.
Well, this is a great palace, Cleo, but what's this, the gift shop?
Oh, no, that is my snowball collection. Gather around, everyone. I have something very personal to share with you. I collect snowballs. It's just one of my very favorite hobbies. Well, now that I've let my guard down and we've all become closer, let's party.
That's right, big American girl. Let's swing.
Paco. You know, that's already getting old.
Well, nice home, Miss McAfee.
In a blender, don't you think? It really is tough.
Say, who's Mr. Strong Jawline here?
Jack, that was in a drawer in my bedroom.
Well, don't tell me what I already know. Just tell me who he is.
But you throw a great party, don't you, Julie?
She sure does. Oh, that's why I wanted you all to come here, so you could see the other side of me. You know, someone who's warm and comfortable and carefree and likes to just kick back and... Whoops! It's 10:45. Okay, everybody, work tomorrow. Come on, get home. Time to go home. Drive safely. Good night. Thank you. Thank you for coming. Okay, no. Work in the morning. Yes. Time to go. Bye-bye. Bye. Good night. Drive safely. Okay, whoops. They like me. The workers really like me.
Some more than others.
Jack, why are you still here?
For the same reason you invited me in the first place. You need a friend. Okay, so you're spending so much time trying to get these people to accept you, but don't you see you're not like them? You're like me. We're above them. We're kindred spirits.
Are you finished, Jack?
Well, it is Halloween Eve, Casey, and I still have three little words. Trick or treat.
And I have three little words for you, Jack. 911.
Morning, guys. Super party last night, huh?
Absolutely. Hey,
Are you sure you wanted me to have all that stuff in the box you gave me?
Oh, you bet, Parker.
Thanks. I couldn't believe it when I found this Roberto Clemente baseball card in there.
Wait a minute, that was in there?
Roberto Clemente. Ooh, and it's a rookie card, too. Well, that's got to be worth $500 or $600. Okay, Kaplan, let's see you try to grovel your way out of this one.
Hey, I don't grovel.
Oh. Yeah, but you want it back, don't you?
Well, of course he does, Puck. Well, the man's licking popsicle wrappers for lunch. I mean...
That is not true, Jack, and I do not grovel. I never grovel.
Okay.
I said Paco can have it, he can have it.
You sure, Hank?
Sure as shooting, Paco.
Okay.
Morning, Casey. I just wanted to tell you how much fun we had last night.
Yeah,
that was great.
Don't give me that. I've never been so hurt in my entire life.
What's wrong?
One of you is a thief.
A thief?
Somebody stole one of my snowballs. The blue one from Guam with the cute little surfing lizard inside it. I invited you people into my home, and this is the thanks I get.
Who would be low enough to steal something right out of her house?
Yeah, who'd be that low?
Just a minute here. I may have stolen a lot of widows' pensions, but I draw the line at Casey's snowballs.
You know, this is crazy. Now, who in the world would steal a lousy snowball globe?
Annie?
Huh? Have you ever stolen anything before?
Well, once. When I was 10, I stole my Uncle Chet's false teeth.
Why? Did he bite you?
No. He gave me an easy bake oven for Christmas.
Okay, I'm lost.
My Uncle Chet was the crankiest man alive. And he tried to make up for it by giving presents. Can't stand someone who's mean one minute and nice the next. I just couldn't confront him.
So you stole his false teeth?
And flush them down the toilet.
Okay, I understand about Casey, and I understand why you have a hard time confronting her. But I still don't understand why you had to steal her snowball.
It's obvious, Annie. She doesn't have false teeth.
I didn't do it. You understand? You gotta believe me. I'm innocent. Now, it isn't very often I can say that without perjuring myself. But I'm innocent. I'm being wrongly accused, just like Dr. Richard Kimball. And my one-armed man is right here in this hospital, and he's holding your snowball and my good name in his hands. Well, actually, it would be one hand. Now, come on, you've got to believe me.
Oh, I do believe you,
no,
Jack.
No, but you don't understand. I'm innocent. You do believe me? Really? Why?
But, Jack, you wouldn't steal a snowball. You're a much bigger crook than that.
Thank you.
Well, it's got to be somebody else. I mean, one of my staff resents me and wants to hurt me.
Could be any one of them. It could be all of them.
All of them.
It's like I told you before, they're not like us, and it's eating them alive.
Well, then, who could it be?
I don't know, but I'm going to find out.
You do that?
Oh, yes. Casey, this is my chance to prove to you who your real friend is.
Jack.
Yes?
You're not using my personal hardship as an opportunity to get closer to me, are you?
Absolutely not. Well, some digs Casey's got, huh? Pucko?
You ain't kidding.
Must hurt to get a glimpse of real privilege, eh?
What are you getting at, Jack?
Well, it certainly must have occurred to you, Paco, that as low man around here, you're a prime suspect in the snowball caper.
Nah, I just figured you did it.
Paco, you know, I was just thinking.
Now, hold on here, Kaplan. We were talking. Talking about snowballs. Say, what do you think one of those might be worth? Doctor.
Well, I'm sure the sentimental value.
Exactly. Sentimental value alone would make it worth the king's ransom.
Right. You know, it's funny Jack should mention sentiment, because, Pac, I was just thinking back to the first trip I ever took to Shea Stadium with my dad. To see a strapping young Puerto Rican outfielder named Clemente.
Won't work, Hank. You said I could have it.
Oh, come on, Paco. I'm broke.
Of course you are, Kaplan. So who'd blame you for copping that snowball?
I didn't cop any snowball.
No?
No, I just figured you took it.
Ms. McAfee, I need to talk to you.
Julie, you're out on the floor all day. Why do people resent me?
Well, actually, I do have a theory. I think it has to do with some people's inability to confront others.
Quiet, Julie, I'm thinking.
Okay. Well, you know what? I just realized something.
What?
It's not my problem. I'm me. I'm the very best me I can be. And if people can't handle that, then that's just too bad.
Well, that's the spirit. So, I bet you can forget all about that silly old snowball, huh?
Oh, Julie, I'm never going to forget about that. It's burned in my memory. And when I find out who did it, I'm going to make their every day in this hospital a living, breathing hell. Now, what were you saying about confrontation?
Nothing.
How'd it go? Did you tell her?
Oh, I couldn't, Annie. She scares me. When she gets mad, she stays pretty. But her pupils get real small, like those Village of the Damned kids.
So you didn't say anything about taking the snowball from her house?
No. And you know what's worse?
What?
I took this one from her desk.
All right, level with me, Annie. You took that snowball just to chafe Casey's hide. Admit it.
Jack, get the hell away from me.
Oh, you're cool. Almost too cool. In fact, when Casey accused us all of stealing, you didn't bat an eyelash. Try to explain that.
Easy, I just figured you did it.
Annie, I put the two specimens in my locker.
So, Julie, tell me, what sort of person do you think would steal a snowball?
I think it was a good person who was manifesting anger at Miss McAfee by taking the one thing she held most dear.
So you don't think it was me?
Of course not, Jack. Why would you steal Miss McAfee's snowball?
Why, indeed. Excuse me. I have a score to settle with a one-armed man.
Why don't men ever just say they gotta go to the bathroom?
This better be good, Jack. I just realized there's another snowball missing from my desk.
Well, indulge me for a moment, would you? You see, part of solving a mystery is discerning patterns. Now, I talked to everyone that went to your party, and a pattern did indeed emerge. They all thought I did it. All but one, that is, and that's Julie Milbury. Now, shall we take a look in Julie's locker?
My snowball. How did they get in Julie's locker?
Maybe you should ask Julie.
Oh, you found them, huh?
Yes, Julie, and I'm furious.
Ooh, I can see that. Your pupils are like tiny pinpoints. Miss McAfee, did I ever tell you about my Uncle Chet?
Not that I recall.
Oh, he was a very cranky man. Gave me an easy bake oven when I was 10.
Julie, how old are you at the end of this story?
The truth is, Miss McAfee, I stole the snowballs and hid them right there in my locker.
Julie? I think I understand what you were trying to tell me earlier. You have a problem confronting people.
Yes, Miss McAfee.
So when Jack asked you to go along with this, you just didn't know how to say no.
No,
it's too late now.
Hey, whoa, wait a minute.
I knew you did it.
You planned this all along to get on my good side. To think that you would steal my property and then talk poor Julie into taking the rap for you.
Well, no, that's not what happened. She took them.
It's true.
Yes.
Oh, my dear, poor sweet girl. I know he's a charmer and a silver-tongued devil, but this slimy toad is a bad influence.
Really think I'm a charmer?
I said slimy toad.
You also said charmer.
I'm not going to blame you for this, dear.
Hey, wait a minute. No, I didn't do it. Don't you realize I'm the only one you can trust? I'm your only friend. I cannot win. I didn't do it. You know what I mean? What can I say? I really didn't do it. I mean, you confessed to it, and she still thinks...
I know, Jeff. I'm sorry. But at least deep down inside, you'll always know you're an innocent man.
Thank you, Julie. And it means a lot coming from a psychotic kleptomaniac.
Hey.
Yeah?
I know it's early, but I want to give you a little wedding gift.
A Roberto Clemente rookie card. Yeah, you were going to give this back to me all the time, weren't you?
Nah. I just couldn't stand your whining and badgering.
You know, at least I didn't grovel. Oh, thanks, Paco. But, you know, sometimes I feel a little guilty taking it back.
Oh, don't worry. I'll still get plenty from that Mickey Mantle card.
Look, Mickey Mantle, there was no Mickey Mantle card in there. Was there?
Okay, now let me get this straight. Even though you confess, she still thinks Jack did
it? I didn't do it. I didn't do it. I really didn't. Isn't that funny? I really didn't do it. I don't think I did. But I didn't actually.
I guess it always pays to tell the truth.
Hi, gang. It's me, your friend, again.
Oh, great.
I'm just so relieved that this matter is finally behind us that I want to take my favorite nurses out for lunch, two at a time.
Oh, gee, well,
I have you two down for Thursday, 12:30 sharp. Follow me in your own car, okay? It's so great to know who your friends are. Annie, you think she's being sincere?
No way.
Me neither.
Oh, you're still in town. This is Paco Ortiz. I hope you don't mind, but I got your number from Dr. Hank Kaplan. Yeah, he thought, you know, you and I should get together. I have to tell you, it's been a long time for me. Yeah, sure I'm nervous. Doesn't everybody get nervous? Okay, great. Well, Friday at 9 would be great. Let's just take care of the cavity this time, and then we can make an appointment for the teeth cleaning later. Thank you, Dr. Melnis. Okay.
Okay. No. Now wait. No, don't leave. I have more.
Yes. Yes.
Why?
Jack. I don't know. Well,
they're not like us, and we're not like them. And if we keep going around like this, I'm going to get dizzy and fall down.
But you throw a great party, don't you, Julie?
She sure does. Oh, that's why I wanted you all to come here, so you could see the other side of me. You know, someone who's warm and comfortable and carefree and likes to just kick back and... Whoops! It's 10:45. Okay, everybody, work tomorrow. Come on, get home. Time to go home. Drive safely. Good night. Thank Thank you for coming. Okay, no. Work in the morning. Yes. Time to go. Bye-bye. Bye. Good night. Drive safely. Okay. Good night. They like me. The workers really like me.
Some more than others.
Jack, why are you still here?
For the same reason you invited me in the first place. You need a friend. Okay, so you're spending so much time trying to get these people to accept you, but don't you see you're not like them? You're like me. We're above them. We're kindred spirits.
Are you finished, Jack?
Well, it is Halloween Eve, Casey, and I still have three little words. Trick or treat.
And I have three little words for you, Jack. 911.
Morning, guys. Super party last night, huh?
Absolutely. Hey, are you sure you wanted me to have all that stuff in the box you gave me?
Oh, you bet, Paco.
Thanks. I couldn't believe it when I found this Roberto Clemente baseball card in there.
Wait a minute, that was in there?
Roberto Clemente. Ooh, and it's a rookie card, too. Well, that's got to be worth...
Lucy.
Well, I don't blame you with all the wedding plans.
And this morning sickness.
All the emotion and the queasiness.
And the romance.
The dry mouth.
And now you're getting married.
So much to think about. What are you going to do first, huh?
I think I'm going to be sick.
How's Gina feel?
Oh, she must feel better. I brought her back to my place to rest. She ended up cleaning.
Yeah, I hear pregnant women really get that nesting instinct.
Well, actually, it started with her clearing a path to my bathroom. Ended up with all my guy stuff in a box. But, Paco, it's all yours now.
Mine?
Yeah, I'm passing the bachelor torch on to you. Yeah, including... my little black book. Yeah, I guess I won't be needing that special item anymore.
I guess not. There's only two numbers in here. And one of them's your dentist.
Annie, I've been thinking. You people put me on a pedestal so high, you're afraid to be my friends.
Well...
Nurses is taped in front of a studio audience.
Listen, Fred, I gotta work tomorrow, so I need you to give out the Halloween candy. What do you mean you ate it all? So go buy some more. No, Fred, no trick-or-treater's gonna want a fistful of beer nuts.
Fred's giving out the candy this year, huh?
Does he do anything to scare the kids?
Oh, yeah. He sits on the porch in that old polyester jogging suit of his, trimming his toenails. Scares the hell out of the kids and the neighbors.
What are we all enjoying so much?
Oh, nothing.
Annie. Sometimes I feel like I'm just not part of the gang. Why is that?
Well, gee, I don't suppose it's because you threatened to fire everybody here at least twice.
Well, that doesn't mean I can't be part of the gang.
Hey, it's Hank and Gina. They're back from San Pequeno, everyone.
Oh, and already dressed for Halloween, I see.
We came directly from the airport to make a special announcement.
Gina said, yes, we are engaged to be married.
Now, That is just terrific. When will you be coming back to work, dear?
Well, I am getting married, so I have a wedding to plan, and then I thought I'd have the baby. Then a small amount of recovery time would be nice.
Oh, you take all the time you need, secure in the knowledge that your paid vacation ended 9 days ago.
So, this must be an exciting time for you.
Well, I am feeling a little woo.
If that works for you.
You know, I want to be part of the gang. You know, I'm just not a corporate businesswoman sitting in her ivory tower. I'm a very, very warm person. It's all here in this memo.
Gather around, gay. I have an announcement to make.
I want to invite you all to my house tomorrow night for a Halloween / get to know me party.
You're really inviting us to your home?
You bet.
That's great.
All right. What time?
Jack, when I said everyone, I didn't know you were standing there. But just to show the gang how fun and spontaneous I can be, you're invited too.
What?
No. Just because we shun and distrust Jack at work doesn't mean we can't shun and distrust Jack at a party as well.
Think about it.
Cleopatra, Miss McAfee, you look terrific.
Oh, thank you, Julie. And don't you make the cutest little kangaroo?
Marsupial. See, a kangaroo has a long and powerful tail. I ran out of fabric. So technically, I'm a marsupial, not specifically a kangaroo or a possum or a wombat or...
Oh, whatever you are, I'm very impressed. It clearly took a lot of work.
And I'm Dr. Bunny. Yeah, short notice, low budget. It's the best Gina could come up with.
Oh, how is Gina? I'm so sorry she couldn't come tonight.
Oh, she really wishes she could come, but she's feeling better.
Oh, will you tell her to please call me if she needs anything?
Oh, that's nice. It's genuinely nice. Stand and deliver.
But Jack, for a minute there, I thought maybe you weren't coming.
Hood, ma'am. The name is Robin Hood. I steal from the rich and hope they don't notice. Wow, what a costume. Looks like I picked a bad night to wear tights.
What's that in my quiver? What is that? Something special for the hostess?
Just a split of champagne, just enough for two.
Oh, isn't that nice? Right. Why don't you split it with Hank?
Hey, guys and foxes, let's swing!
Paco, you're wild and crazy!
That's your problem, sick machine!
Great costume. You must have searched all over town for those ridiculous 70s clothes.
No, actually, they were in a box of stuff Hank gave me.
It was my costume from last year.
And your work clothes from the year before.
Well, this is a great palace, Cleo, but what's this, the gift shop?
Oh, no, that is my snowball collection. Gather round, everyone. I have something very personal to share with you. I collect snowballs. It's just one of my very favorite hobbies. Well, now that I've let my guard down and we've all become closer, let's party.
That's right, big American girl. Let's swing.
Paco. You know, that's already getting old.
Well, nice home, Miss McAfee.
Put it in a blender, don't you think? It really is
tough. Say, who's Mr. Strong Jawline here?
Jack, that was in a drawer in my bedroom.
Well, don't tell me what I already know. Just tell me who he is.